Wondering how to use the Amidamide Joy breast pump? Then stick around. In this video, I am going to break down the different components as well as settings and how to use your Myo Joy breast pump. So to start, this is your Myo Joy pump motor. This is what creates and drives your suction. It is operated by these four buttons, and you can monitor and track your pumping session via the LED screen. Now, this is powered via a plug-in charger. However, you can also operate this portably via four AA batteries. This is not a rechargeable unit, so if you are using batteries, these will need to get replaced once they are drained. Okay, so let's take a look at your collection container. So first of all, it is a pump to bottle setup. You have your Amida bottles. These are a 4 ounce. They can be standing upright using your bottle stand. Next, you have your duckbill valve, and then pull this off, your flange. So your flange comes in a 25mm, or there also is a larger 28.5mm flange. So that is simply the diameter of your flange tunnel. If you need a smaller flange, you can also purchase flange inserts separately, which will minimize or reduce the size of your tunnel to better fit your nipple. We have our diaphragm, and then we have your adapter cap, which attaches to your tubing, and then you have your tubing adapter. So I will go through these in more detail as we go through the video, but let's look at how to put this all back together. So first, you are going to want to take your diaphragm and place that into the top of your flange. Make sure that it's on nice and firm, and we're going to want to secure that with your tubing cap. Now that firmly goes onto place, and you will hear that clip on. Then we are going to want to take your duckbill valve and attach it to the bottom of your flange. Now that just pushes on nice and firm, and then this screws on to your bottle. Oops, if I get that on properly. And there we go, it is back completed again. Now to attach this to your pump, depending if you are doing a single or a double pump, will depend on how you attach this. So you can see on your tubing adapter that you have two tubings connected. Now this is for double pumping. If you are wanting to swap this to single pumping, you simply remove one of the tubings and you push this end cap into the other end. Now this has taken this pump to a single. You can remove your other collection container, and that is now a single pumping. You attach the connector adapter into the side of your pump. All right, so let's go about and turn this on. So I am using your plug-in adapter. When we turn this on, we simply press the power button. Now your pump comes with two modes. You have your stimulation, which is your short suctions, which are to initiate your letdown. So you want to run this for around 2 minutes or until your milk flow comes in. Once your milk flow has come in, you want to press the M and switch over to your expression mode. Now, this will automatically transfer over after 2 minutes for you. So if you do forget, it will automatically do it for you. So you only have the two settings, but the other controls that you do have are your vacuum strength. So I always recommend starting on a lower level, a one or a two, and then slowly working your way up until you find a suction that is comfortable for you. So you want something that's strong but has to be comfortable. And you can simply adjust that up and down with the minus or the plus button. You can see on here that you also have a timer, so you can easily track how long you have been pumping for. So when we want to attach our pump, so prior to our session, you are going to want to aim for your nipple to be inside your tunnel. It needs to be free moving. You don't want it to be too tight inside or too loose. Now I'll show you, they have a great diagram in your book. So we are aiming for a good fit where there's a tiny bit of room, but so your nipple can move freely in and out. You don't want it too large where your nipple is not going all the way, or sorry, too small where your nipple is not getting sucked all the way through, because that will cause rubbing and quite a lot of pain. And again, you don't want to have your areola being drawn into the tunnel either with a too large flange, because again, this will be painful. So we are really aiming for a nice free flowing nipple without the areola inside. So you can, if your flange is too large, you can get a flange insert to go inside, and that simply sits in here, or you can swap for the larger flange size provided. So once you have the correct flange fit, we are going to imagine my hand is your breast. We're going to simply want to align that on with our nipple within the tunnel. Start your pumping session, go through your stimulation mode till your letdown comes in, and then you are going to go on the expression mode for around 15 to 20 minutes. Once you have finished your pumping session, you are going to want to lean forward, slightly break the seal by moving your finger in slightly. You don't want to just pull this off without breaking the seal, because you're going to pull your nipple with it and that will be quite painful. So we break the seal gently, remove your pump, then you can simply place that down into your bottle stand while you are removing your other pump if you are double pumping. Once you have removed your pump, you can simply unscrew your bottle. Depending if you are going to be using this straight away or storing, you can place your nipple in for using it straight away, or use the little cap and place that on top and store straight away. Now, once you are finished with your breast pump, we are going to need to clean it. So the parts that need to be cleaned are all the parts that come in contact with your breast pump. So your adapter cap does not come in contact with any breast milk, neither does your tubing or your pump. So these do not need to be washed and sterilized. The parts that come in contact are your diaphragm, your valve, as well as your flange and any inserts, and then your bottle and bottle cap. So these are the parts that you need to wash in warm soapy water and then sterilize. So you need to be at least sterilizing once a day. To do that, you simply boil these for 5 or so minutes. You can also use the Amita microwave sterilizer bag. Other than that, once these are dry and sterilized, pop them away for storage for use for the next time. I think that covers all of it, but if you do have any questions on how to use your pump, then please ask and I will do my very best to answer them. Thanks.